This show is part of the RetroZap.com podcast network.
Good morning, world. This is Jerome Blake. I played Oppo Rancisis in The Phantom Menace and residually bits in the other prequels. And you're listening to Brews and Blasters.
Here we go.
You're listening to Brews and Blasters. The Star Wars party starts now.
How are we doing?
Same as always.
That bad, huh?
Pokey religions and ancient weapons are no match for a good blaster at your side, kid.
Let us go inside where we can discuss business over a drink.
Did you join the fellow refreshment?
Everyone's invited, of course.
With Chris Salton and Joe Tavano, two guys from Boston, who are talking about this stuff anyway.
Whoa.
Let him marinate with like a good steak tip.
Oh, yeah.
Renegade. They're having a nice time.
We just got a cup of super cold zippy sip.
Yes. He had a barbecue. Society.
Okay, stop.
With that guy.
Dangerous.
What's up, Warheads? This is not going to go the way you think. I don't think it's going to go the way we think either. We're going to talk about Solo. We have a bunch of things to do. We promise email every time. We're actually going to get through this time. A lot to do. See you soon. Whoa. Settle down there. Welcome up. Wow, I'm just scatting. Wow, what happened? I'm probably going to edit that part out. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Brews and Blasters. This is the Star Wars party, of course. My name is Joe. Joining me, as always, my good buddy Chris Salton.
Hey-o.
Hey. Hey, you know, I got this this Luke Skywalker right after the show ended last week. We started playing with the toys.
Yeah.
Yeah. We started taking a couple of sippy sips. As you do. I grabbed the 3 3/4 Stormtrooper Executioner axe, like the vibro axe, and I put it in the 6-inch Luke Skywalker figure's hands, put a little power stance on, and pretty much Luke is playing a vibro axe like guitar right now.
Now he's shredding.
Yeah, now he looks hardcore.
You know what's funny metal. Is the 3.75 and the 6-inch, it works.
It really works, like as a guitar. Like it's perfect guitar size, mm-hmm. And he's shredding right now. He looks like he's born to play guitar. It's pretty much the best accessory Luke could have.
It looks like it was made to do that.
Yeah, and you know what we were made to do? We were made to party. We made to party, Star Wars style.
We do like to party.
We do, and I also like to party.
We like to party.
And I also like to party. Oh, hi, Chris.
Oh, hi, Joe.
When does the Star Wars party begin?
Now. Ooh, okay. You're more familiar.
Yeah, we smoothed them some things
are
out.
Are you familiar?
Are you familiar with the Star Wars Party?
Yeah.
Are you guys? You know, if this is your first time, welcome.
Well, cool.
Yeah, cool. Thanks. Well, cool. Hey, cool.
That's so cool.
Oh, that's great, Mark. Oh, good job.
Is that live?
And I love Lisa so much. You haven't even seen it yet. That's the amazing part. I can't wait to watch this movie with you.
Yeah, I think you said it best when we were talking off air.
It's the absolute worst movie ever made?
No, you're like, hey, you saw all the best parts.
Kind of. I think you should just, you know.
I need to see it, man.
You gotta watch the whole. There's all. Every part is the best part.
Hi, doggy.
Oh, hi, doggy. Like, that scene is, like, so good on like, 12 different levels all at once.
Tommy, you're my best customer.
How do you know all this already?
I watched a lot of stuff on YouTube.
She starts talking before he's even talking.
Yeah. You're my best customer.
Oh, hi, Tommy. I didn't recognize you. Who doesn't recognize this guy?
Yeah.
He looks like the angel of death that's walking to a flower shop.
That was born in Transylvania.
Pretty much. In 1492. Yeah.
He could be.
Tommy
nobody knows. You know, nobody knows his actual
nobody
name.
Nobody knows.
The trouble.
She's a bass.
Yeah.
What's that from?
Spaceballs.
You know. You know.
Are you kidding me?
I'm not kidding you, Chris.
Fool Joel.
I'm not kidding you. Oh, yeah. Hey. We've been talking about it for a while. I want to go right into email.
Emails,
all right?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
This is a show for you guys.
Yeah. No, it's a show for everyone. We're going to do some email right off the bat.
But mainly it's a show for me and Joe.
It's a show us all.
I'm just playing. We love you guys.
It's a show. Chris, any requests on music here?
You put me on the spot. I noticed. You put me on the spot. I go, I...
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It. I can't do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, Chris, favorite macaroni and cheese? Green.
No, I said the white.
The white. You go white.
That was good. That was good, man.
All right.
I am a natural blonde.
Yeah, we are. Yeah, me too.
All the blonde fell out.
Yeah, it stopped when I was 10 years old, but all right.
Yeah, yeah, whatever.
Whatever. What are
the
we talking?
White. That was true. Yeah. That was a good episode. Hey, I don't know which one that one was.
The guy just glazed over. Guy just glazed over.
Yeah, tune in 6 episodes ago. That sounds about right.
That sounds, yeah, somewhere around now.
Did he say a niner?
Yeah, niner.
Okay, yeah, emails.
Yeah, we want to get some emails because we've been promising them, and then we just ran out of time.
Wow, we got a lot.
Some of these I haven't cleaned up. We've read some of these. Don't worry about it.
Still a lot.
Yeah, we're doing all right, though. We're doing all right. It's a good time. All right. Brian writes in, guys, really enjoyed your most recent episode and guest retrocasters. I'll have to give them some of those shows a try. I can't even read
this
right now.
This is the round table, I'm assuming, right?
Yes. One of you guys said something about that rang very true to me. He said the boomers can't suspend their disbelief the way an 8-year-old can. That seems so true that many dissect things so much they can't enjoy them. I love dissecting and collecting Star Wars because it's a hobby. I enjoy it. Interesting point of view. I just want to say something about like the boomers and the Gen X and the millennial. An amazing article I read that last week from the person who created Punisher. Okay. The author. And he wrote this unbelievable article about The Last Jedi, examining how the choices of like the boomer generation represented by Luke, Leia, and Han affected the Gen X generation represented by like Haldo and Poe, and how they're playing off the millennial generation rising up as portrayed by like Rose, Finn, Kylo, and Rey. And a very in-depth interview, and it was unbelievable. I'm trying to find it right now where it's published. It was so good.
You know something, man? Before we get into it,
yeah,
I'm so happy that we're a Bond when we were. Like, I understand, like, we weren't Bond sitting in that theater watching the original trilogy, but we're a Bond when it was on TV before the prequels. We're a Bond in, like, the perfect generation.
I mean, I was born during the movies.
You were, yeah. But I mean, it was. I was born in 85. What were you born?
I was born in 80.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. Before Empire.
Yeah.
Yes.
But I'm happy that I was born.
I love that I that time. Yeah.
If that makes sense.
Jerry Conway wrote it. And it was it's so, so good. Yeah, so good. I loved it.
You look excited, Joe.
Yeah, it was really good. And I love being part of Gen X myself. And I think you're part of the millennial generation, but I think you're...
No!
You are.
That's 90s.
Born in 82 and after.
That's... Oh, whatever.
Yeah, but you are definitely much more akin to the Gen X generation.
They always told me I was an old soul.
It's true, though. You are. You are.
Yeah.
You're much more akin to the Gen X generation. So I dig that. That's why we get along.
Thanks, you know? Joe.
Yeah. Hey. And you brought all my friends here, too. Great job. Man, I'm just trying to find this article that Jerry Conway wrote. And it's just so good. I'm trying to find where it was written about. And the way he broke down the like how the plot plays out is just really, really cool. And
so he went deep.
Yes.
He did some digging.
Oh yeah. Jerry Conway says it's time to talk about Star Wars The Last Jedi. If you just Google Jerry Conway The Last Jedi, you'll get to it. And it's just a really cool article. And you know, he talks about being a populist movie and it's just, I love it. How the choices Rian Johnson made are informed because he's from Gen X, who has grown up with Star Wars, and it's just really, really cool. Rian Johnson deconstructs the myth of a baby boom generation that adopted Star Wars as its foundational fiction. I mean, that's how he starts, and it just digs in. It's a longer read, but I highly, highly implore you guys to check it out.
Well, if you highly recommend it,
yeah,
it's got to be pretty good, man.
Thank you, buddy. That means a lot to me.
Well,
that's
what you do.
I try. I read. All right. Let's see here.
This looks like a long one. I'm going to really enjoy this one.
I got to be honest. I think we read that one like 2 weeks ago, but that's all right. That's all right.
When we were Skyping, we had some technical difficulties.
We did. We had a few.
You're like, hey, what did you think? I'm like, I didn't hear it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's true.
Oh, hi.
Oh, hi.
This is my life.
we're really just, it's pretty much just a disaster artist podcast now. That's it. All right, let's see here. Neil writes in, hey, Brews and Blasters. Now, Neil is pretty much one of our biggest fans, amazing listener, one of the most positive people in Star Wars fandom
met. We need it.
Yeah, I absolutely love TLJ. Great movie, saw it 3 times. Your show is wonderful. A true friend. You're my subscription of the day. Could you do a Star Wars thought of the day at the end of the show? Just an idea for you. Thanks, Neil.
Star Wars thought of the day.
A thought of the day. I mean,
I'm sure we can think of something.
Our entire show is a thought of the day.
Yeah.
It.
What kind
it
of
just
eggs
popped
do you like?
In there? Yeah. Do you guys like the egg talk from last week? Egg talk.
Joe, I mean, there's a handful of things that I really enjoy. I really enjoyed that one.
Yeah, I have a good time.
I like stuff like that.
Yeah. I mean, what's your favorite way to cook eggs right now?
You lost me.
I just want to know. I'm just going to sit here and sip this whiskey while you tell me what the favorite way for you to drink eggs. Go. You're not saying anything. You can't even talk.
You said drink eggs.
I'm going to tear up a drink. You tell me your favorite way to cook eggs.
Oh,
go.
Poached. Boom.
Oh, I didn't even get a sip in.
I love poached eggs, man.
Really? Can you make them?
Hell, well, have I made them?
Yeah, do you know how to make poached eggs?
I'm
well,
sure I could.
She does it for you, doesn't
well,
she?
Well, it was fun. Yeah.
Yeah.
She's like, how'd you want your eggs? And I'm like, poached. She's like, oh. God.
Yeah, it's
now I have to boil water.
It's a pain. You gotta put the it's almost like a mix. You gotta get like the
little vinegar. Yeah.
Little vinegar in there, binding.
Yeah.
You know? But they are nice.
I like it.
I haven't had a poached egg in a few years.
You can put them on top of anything, Joe.
Kid, I'm not gonna lie to you. I might do that tonight. Don't tell them.
Hey, I won't say a word.
Alright. You guys don't tell them either. I'm having poached eggs tonight.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with like late night eggs.
They're good for you.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Lance writes in, Jawa socks. I was wondering what color socks Jawas love to wear other than the black and brown. Does Jawa wear Christmas socks? Happy New Year.
Absolutely not.
You don't think Jawas wear socks?
They don't have the options, I don't think. They're on a deserted planet run by the Hutts.
It's hot.
And it's hot.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I think solid colors is what they have.
Do they wear Christmas socks? No, they wear Life Day socks.
Life Day, yeah.
If they were going to wear, they want to wear Christmas, they would wear Life Day socks.
I think it's solid colors. So maybe like a red, maybe a green. If they get creative, they can wear one red, one green. There you go. Boom.
Yeah, yeah. George writes in, doesn't think Kylo Ren is redeemable. He killed Han Solo, basically. I mean, that's it. It initially bothered me that Rey would give him a chance at all. I mean, she's feeling things from his side of view, I think. What is he, though? You know, because of the bond she had with Han Solo. I think that Kylo manipulated Rey into believing he could turn because he could easily kill Snoke himself, but knew he couldn't defeat the guards on his own. Oh, that's interesting. Like, he basically was, like, lying.
Well, I'll tell you, man. Those guards threw down. And then I don't think he could have took them on by himself. There was, what were they, like, six or eight?
There were eight of them.
Eight of them, yeah.
Four and four.
And I want to know why those
are... Praetorian Guard? Do you have the Praetorian Guard?
Sir, do you have the Praetorian Guards?
Hey, guys, welcome to Force Friday. Just want to let you guys give a couple of ground rules. Just want to set the stage before you guys all go in. Do you have the Praetorian Guard?
Yeah, one poor soul came out. Hey, guys, the T-shirts you promised.
Do you have the Praetorian Guard?
We don't have them.
Do you have the Praetorian Guard?
Sir, I don't know if we have the I don't
Dorian
know about the figures.
Guard.
We don't.
Right.
The T-shirts.
Guard.
That's basically how it went down.
That was it.
I'm telling you next. Hey. I'm wearing slippers, man.
He got that figure.
He got
the figure. There was one of them there. He got the figure. Non-violent.
True story. Non-violent.
Nicest,
one Praetorian guard
kid ever.
In the whole Toys R Us. Two sections. One. He got it.
Nice kid.
That guy got it.
It was right above my head.
I didn't see anything. I was freaking.
Yeah.
You were like, Maz, Praetorian. Hey, I got General Leia. I was like, what am I doing? Dude, I started running.
I don't know if you even want to go this. Like, if they're doing something, I don't even know if I want to go. I want to go. You're right.
2 years ago, we talked about getting jobs just to infiltrate.
Infiltrate, yeah.
Yeah, that's what we should do.
We should do that?
Yeah. I don't even want my paycheck. I don't want the last paycheck. We just want to work that night.
That's it. That's it. What are they doing? They're supposed to be working.
Yeah.
Oh, they quit, I guess. All right. 11:50.
They started screaming. They threw money and they left. They didn't want their change. That's what they said.
Looks like they quit. The store actually has more money now that they've worked here for 5 minutes. All right. Oh,
they bought
man.
$50 worth of figures and left $100. I don't have time.
Yeah. No, I think that Jordan's on to something. I don't think that Kylo never went good.
No.
Rey didn't convince him to go good. When they're in the elevator, Rey's like, you're going to see, I can't wait. Like, we're going to do this, and you're going to go my way. He's like, what are you talking about? I saw the future. You're going to go my way.
Yeah, he's on a one-way track here.
He's like, just stay with me. Everything's going to work out. You're like, are you kidding? You're like, they're both looking at the future, seeing two totally different things. And then he gets Snoke being like, seeing a totally other thing. You know, it's three people looking to the future, seeing different things.
Determination.
Perseverance.
Yeah, this kid's not going backwards. He's going forward, okay?
You know what I thought was crazy? I heard a Star Wars Beyond the Films, I was listening to their analysis. The one thing they brought up that I didn't hear anyone else say, she threw Kylo the hero sword. Like, that sword belongs to me. The one that, like, didn't fly to her.
Ah, gotcha,
she willingly gave it away to him because that's how much she put her faith in him, that he was going to go good. You know, she really thought she could bring him back.
She shed a tear.
She did. She thought she could bring him back.
I mean, that she's not naive, though.
Yeah, she knew. She's like, nah, it ain't happening.
Yeah, like,
Luke was way more naive.
Leia was like, she understood, listen, he's gone. And at the end of that movie, Rey's like, he's gone.
Mm-hmm.
The dude is gone now. We're moving past that.
Yeah.
He's Supreme Leader Ren now, apparently.
Or he's going to pretend that Snoke's still alive.
That's, you know something? That could be like the dirty little secret between Kylo and Fox.
A lot of people are like saying, you know, like, you know, the king is dead, long live the king. Like, oh yeah. People are just thinking like, he'll take on the mantle of Supreme Leader. What if he's like, oh no, Supreme Leader's fine. Don't go in there. Yeah. I talk now.
He's really grumpy.
Yeah, he's going to be angry forever now. Like, he cannot be bothered. Don't ever bother him. Yes, yeah, the Praetorians are fine.
He's not taking calls. The Praetorian guys, they're on break. Don't worry about
it. Go through me.
But there's two tall guys with robes and, like, blue eyes.
Where did they go?
Where are they?
We need to look.
Why
that
do those dignitaries always get away?
They're navigators.
Navigators, dignitaries, whatever. Yeah.
Did they burn up? Where did they go?
They went somewhere.
I do want to know.
Who are they? They look tall.
Yeah. I wonder. Yeah, that's really weird. Yeah, and, you know, George has a lot of good ideas there. Great, great email there. Misty says, hey guys, listen to your show all the time and I'm an avid fan of the Collector's Hut. We know you, Misty. You're the greatest. Thank you so much. Looking for patches. We were just mentioning before. Those patches are getting sent. We said last week.
Yeah.
We were a little busy with the babies, you know?
We have babies.
Yeah, we have babies on the way. Yeah. Been a wild ride these past few months.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Gotta say.
It is crazy.
It has been crazy.
I'll tell you this, though. Misty, yeah. We're going to get you out a patch.
Yeah, you got patches coming to you. Don't worry. We got stuff going on. We got RetroZap stuff. We got Collector's Hut stuff. We got Oppo.
There's a lot of stuff.
Wonder why? Because Misty supports the show. She left an iTunes review. She did.
Nice.
She did. She writes the emails.
There you go.
You know, be part of the club. Be like Misty. Seriously.
Whoa, look at all of this.
Oh, have you seen this yet?
Oh, hi.
Oh, hi, Ewan.
I did see it, yeah.
Yeah.
You know what's funny? This dude could have been working out and one of his, like, I don't know, nutritionist was like, I'm going to snap a picture. Hashtag OB.
Well, that's what happened. But he's growing the beard.
He is growing the beard.
The hair is grown out.
It's happening.
He's growing out. He's combing it the right way, buddy.
Yes.
He's like, oh, no, it's not happening.
He's getting the tan. Tatooine, two suns.
Two sun tan. It's happening. Kenobi is happening. We're looking at pictures of Ewan McGregor.
He's in. He wants to do it.
The beard is back. You know, he's looking thin. He's working out. I got to tell you, he's getting the cheeks that look like Alec Guinness in that movie, you know? Thin cheeks.
You know what's insane? His accent is so strong, man. And then
he has a great Scottish accent. Yeah.
Yeah, but he just turned... It's a light switch,
off.
Man. Light switch.
He's one of the greatest actors of our time.
Probably, man. He's unbelievable.
Tell me otherwise. Let's go. Tell me otherwise. I'm throwing down on Ewan McGregor being one of the greatest actors of all time. It's true. I'll go toe to toe.
If you want him to do something, he does it.
I'll go toe to toe on that one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Star Wars, Big Fish.
We've never played this one.
I was going to say, this is like 1991 club music.
This is RoboCop 3 video game.
Yeah, ooh, RoboCop 3. That was a dark movie, man.
He flew in that one, right?
He flew in that one, and then his partner, she died.
Ooh.
What was her name?
I don't know.
I don't remember either. He was Alex Murphy.
Yeah, Murphy.
And she was something.
Awesome.
She was cool.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
She was tough.
Let us know.
Brews and Blasters at RetroZap.com. If you know the name without Googling, don't Google. We'll know if you do. We'll know. We'll know.
Oh, what was her name?
Yeah.
She was a cool chick, man. She was in 3 movies.
Okay, Google. RoboCop partner name. That's not happening. It didn't work.
What's going to happen is on the way home, I'm going to be like, oh!
Yeah, seriously. Ann Lewis.
That's
Lewis.
Lewis.
Murphy
that's it.
And Lewis.
Damn.
Yeah, that's it. I found it. So
Star Wars podcast.
No more of that. No more of that death contest. All right. We had a good idea there, but we're just not going to do it.
It was a good one, though.
Should we edit that out?
No.
All right. We have some Oppo Awards we got to go through.
Oh, I like that.
You want some?
I like that.
All right.
Hey, I watched Con Air the other night.
Why?
You know something? The dialogue's really bad, but the movie's good.
All right, cool.
Good talk, right?
Yeah. Love the show. Listen to Chris and Joe remind me of a discussion around the high school lunch table back in the day, talking about Star Wars. Easily the most fun and funniest Star Wars podcast on the net. The Force is strong with this one.
Ooh.
Nice. Huge Star Wars fan here. It seems there isn't enough Star Wars audio content, and these fellas fill the void. I can now listen to lore and different takes on events in the universe while driving to and from work. Thank you, Joe. Chris, please keep it up. You guys keep me wanting to learn more about the Star Wars universe and make me laugh while doing it. Boom.
You know something? That's the drive that keeps us going.
Yeah, it really does.
You know, I like that. I like that someone, number one, I don't know why we're entertaining, but I'm glad that we're entertaining to some.
Yeah, seriously. It makes us real happy. Because there are days.
Yeah.
There are days.
Like, I'm like, hey, Joe.
Yeah.
You want to get a sub?
Oh, I know. I go for a sub right now.
Yeah, we need to eat, man.
We really do.
Like, not tonight, but we need to eat.
We need to get together.
Yeah.
And do some eating.
Yeah.
Poached eggs.
Drinking, eating. Hey, yeah. You took me to a nice breakfast place that time.
Yeah, that was good. Maria's?
Yeah, that was good.
That was good stuff. We can go back there.
Yeah.
We can go to a new place. So we still got to go to that diner.
Which one?
The one that, remember we were going to go? The little depot?
Oh, it's new ownership now.
What happened?
No, it's the same stuff. So they were smart about it.
All right. Yeah. So, but they sold it though, huh?
They did. They're not there no more.
They were good. The old owners. I don't know.
Yeah, it was a little weird.
All right. New Oppo Award, Boston's finest. You know that feeling when you get a certain something that gives you joy? Brews and Blasters, just that. I can imagine them sitting at Dexter's Diner, sipping a brew. They just blend in the Star Wars galaxy seamlessly. Only one word left for them. Genius! Thanks.
I like it, man. That's a good one. Nice. That was really good.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Dax.
Yeah, there you go. This isn't a wretched hive scum and villainy. Star Wars and culture talk at its finest. Culture.
Okay. Box trolls.
How have we not talked about this yet?
Box trolls?
Canto Bite.
Oh, Canto Bite, yeah.
That's Canto Bite is society.
It's so true, man.
Society on high.
Well, I like the little drunk leprechaun guy.
Sorry. That's it. That's a whole planet of society right there.
High
society planet.
If I meet Ryan Johnson one day, yeah. I'm going to ask him, is there cheese on Canto Bite?
If there were ever a place for it, it would have been there.
It would have been there. Like, hey, been do you guys there. Like port, you know?
Port wine, pub cheese?
Pub cheese.
Pub cheese.
I don't know if you ever heard of us. We like pub cheese. We're those guys.
Yeah. Before the movie, we eat pub cheese.
Yeah. We're the one that photoshopped pub cheese and the Emperor. Are you familiar? Yeah. Palpatine.
Palpatine, Emperor, pub cheese.
They eat pub cheese.
They have a party before. Yeah.
Him and the dignitaries, the purple guys.
Do you think the navigators in Snoke ate the pub cheese too?
They got to eat.
Yeah, they got to eat. We all got to eat.
That's probably where they went. They were on lunch break. And then Snoke got killed. Everyone got killed.
They come back. It's all on fire.
One of the Praetorian guides turned into a confetti.
Yeah, do you imagine that they went on lunch break, they come back, all the Praetorian guards are confetti, Snoke is dead and in half, everything burned up,
I would take
it was
a
all
ship.
On fire.
I would look at the other one and go, we're taking a ship.
This is ours now.
Yep, it's ours now. Yeah. We earned that.
Yeah, but then the ship blows up and, like, you know, 2 minutes later.
Half of the ship is blown up. That's the weird part.
Oh, they're still flying half a ship, huh?
It's that big.
It is huge.
That's what blew my mind.
The whole ship went down, though, and every other ship went down, too.
But it seemed like they took their time. Like, they were like, hey, the east wing is gone.
Yeah, yeah, we're going to fall in 5 days.
Yeah, exactly, yeah, yeah. We get a week.
Yeah, we pretty much do.
Get it together, grab your belongings.
Yeah, yeah, you got time. Oh, you're dying.
Yeah,
I gotcha.
Don't worry. Yeah, clean out your office. We're okay.
Yeah, that's like something happening, like we're in Boston. That would be like something happening in like Indonesia.
Right.
Shout out to all our Indonesian fans.
We're big in Brunei.
Brunei. We are big in Brunei.
Huge.
Huge.
Big shout out.
Huge. Yeah.
Yeah.
I.
Yes. All right, what do we got?
What's the yellow thing mean?
What?
That yellow line. What's
that's,
that?
That's the email. You know.
It's fancy stuff, man. I'm not used to the new technology.
It's real fancy. Want to do some voicemails?
Yeah. Are you? We have voicemail?
We got some voicemail.
You know that's my favorite.
I know. You love it. Wow.
It is interesting.
All right. Well, we'll do some voicemail.
I mean, we don't know what we're getting into right now, right?
No, we don't.
Oh.
Oh, man. Going in blind.
The great unknown.
Yeah. Don't get weird on us. Not too weird, at least. If we can't play it, then, you know.
Imagine if Sam Rockwell was like, hey, guys, hey, I just want to let you know I got a Golden Globe. Like, thanks for calling in.
Hey, Joe. Hey, Chris. Everybody at RetroZap. This is Michael O'Connor calling in from the Power of the Prequels and George Shot First and Bond Night on RetroZap. I just wanted to chime in on my thoughts. I'm sorry I couldn't make the big show. I hope everybody is having a great time and is getting to talk about all the fun things that they enjoyed from the Last Jedi. I just wanted to chime in with my two cents and keep it short. I just saw it a few minutes ago, and I will say that I'm a little bit of a mixed bag on it, but I do probably enjoy it more than either of the other two Disney Star Wars films. And there were some legitimate moments in this film that, for me, felt like the first time since George Lucas left the franchise that there were some great Star Wars scenes that really had the heart and the integrity of the films that I loved growing up. I really loved some of the humor in the film. I loved Chewbacca's scenes with the Porgs and some of the stuff with Luke Skywalker and Princess Leia and then some of the new characters as well with Rose and Finn going on their adventure and some of the interesting political subtext of all that, which I had a lot of fun when they go to Canto Bight. So overall, you know, like I said, mixed bag. I definitely have some concerns, some things that I wasn't as crazy about, but I'm trying to keep it positive. And, you know, I'm trying to, you know, put out, you know, the good side of the Force rather than focus on the negative as Master Yoda would have us do. But anyway, I hope everybody's having a great time. And I do just want to say that however you feel about the new Star Wars film, let's keep it positive in the fandom, guys. Let's enjoy what we enjoy and spread the love and focus on the good things and not dwell too much on the dark side of the Force, not dwell too much on hate and anger and frustration. Everybody's got a favorite Star Wars movie that they love. And if this one wasn't your favorite Star Wars movie, you can go back and watch your favorites. If this was, then I'm glad to hear it. And I'm sure you've got more coming up down the line. So thanks so much for letting me come in and put in my two cents. And hope everybody's doing great. All right. Bye now, and may the Force be with you.
That was amazing.
That was solid.
Solid, solid voicemail. That's how it's done. Michael O'Connor, the man.
Yeah.
Great ideas, great thoughts there. I like that he said it goes back to how he felt about Lucas era. Because that's how I felt. I felt like Johnson really got the heart of a movie Lucas would do.
Right.
You know, I really, really feel that. Yeah, I really dig that. So that's cool.
I just loved how everything was like positive.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, totally. You know, even when it's a mixed bag for him, he still is focusing on the positive, right?
He's still focused. Yeah, exactly. You know, in we did hear like a handful of things being like, oh, was, you know, stuff about Canto Bight. And the thing is that Canto Bight was very necessary.
It was.
And I'm very happy that he enjoyed that.
Yeah, me too. It's just so formative for who Finn is as a character and his decision to become a full-fledged rebel and a member of the Resistance. At that time, he's just, before Canto Bight, he's just looking at himself and Rey and his friends and getting away. He was much closer to what DJ felt, but not joining, don't being part of it.
Yeah, he was looking to bail.
He felt stuck in the middle.
But what was really nice about Canto Bight is that, you know, even though something extreme is going on in the universe, we just got a glimpse of what else is going on in the universe.
Yeah.
So,
but that look that he got at all that going on, that inspired him.
Well, I mean,
that inspired him to take sides.
Talk about like
take up a fight, not wanting to be left in, not wanting to be one of those people.
Well, it was like changing your mind instantly yeah. because he was like, wow, look at this place. This place is amazing. And then he yeah. listens to Rose and he's just like, yeah, this place is, it's not what it's cracked up to be.
This is not who I want to be. And yeah. this is not what I want to aspire yeah. to be.
Look closer.
And by the time he fights Phasma, he's like, yeah, I'm rebel scum.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I'm not, you know, I'm rebel. Like yeah. I declare. I'm rebel now.
Yeah, he's not bailing out now.
No, he's part of it.
He's full in.
And he's so all in, he's ready to kill himself for the rebellion.
Yeah. Oh, true to that.
You know?
You know what's crazy, man? Most movies, like, is predictable. And I was like...
I thought he was gone. I thought that's it.
I thought for sure, because it was, like, prolonged. And I was like, no, they're not going to... Oh, I think they're going to.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I could not believe he was saved.
I was fully convinced. I was like, wow, they're really pulling out, like, all the stops yeah. here.
And then you get this amazing, like, wisdom from Rose about, like, it's not fighting what we hate. It's about protecting what we love. And I'm like,
yeah.
oh, like, they're going there. They're yeah. going. That's Lucas right there.
I saved you.
That's Jedi right there. That's yeah. for real.
Hello, Chris and Joe. Well, your voicemail still told me to tell you about Twilight of the Apprentice.
Sure does.
I already covered that. So I'm going to talk to you about The Last Jedi. Oh, by the way, it's Jacob Roth from Laramie, Wyoming.
Jacob!
Since episode one.
Old school.
So I just got out of my second viewing of The Last Jedi.
He's listened to every episode since episode one.
I had no idea what to think. All day people were asking me how I felt about the movie, and I couldn't give them a straight answer. I had to respond with, I have no idea. My mind is just so boggled right now with all the twists and turns in it. I don't want to spoil it for you. But I'm going to have to see it again, is what I would tell all my friends. And so, what did I do tonight? Of course, I went to go see it again. And after the second viewing, it will be much easier to answer this question with a resounding yes. Oh my gosh, this movie was absolutely awesome. I really do think it probably takes a couple of viewings to get the full awesomeness of the movie. I'm just going to kind of focus on a couple of my favorite parts of the movie. My favorite part overall was that opening scene. We got to see Poe be the biggest badass in the galaxy. I think
True.
He's definitely the best pilot in Star Wars history. Sorry, Han, but you have Chewie, who also got to show off his skill of being an ace pilot. That was also a very cool scene. Another scene that really stuck out to me was Luke and R2's reunite.
I love that scene.
Reuniting on the Millennium Falcon.
That's all Hamill, too.
This scene was just so powerful. Just that iconic message from Leia, and it made it even more impactful. Since Carrie Fisher's no longer with us.
And you get, like, Archie's morals.
Last point I'd like to focus on here is Rey's second offering of the lightsaber to Luke. I caught it the first time, but it just didn't have that big of an impact on me. After the second viewing, the fact that Luke denied it again just showed how broken of a man he is. Well, that's all I got for you today, boys. Keep up the good work, and remember, the Force will be with you, always.
Jacob's the man.
He is the man.
True believer. He's been with us since the very beginning. Thank you so much. And amazing, amazing email. Voicemail. What am I saying? You know. And I don't know if we'll ever change The Twilight of the Apprentice. I'm going to just keep there forever.
Maybe when Rebels isn't around anymore.
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe.
But then again, maybe not.
Yeah.
Bootini! Calling you guys from the road. Quick lightning plot hole question to put to you guys.
Go for it.
What the hell happened to the purple navigators?
Oh,
when Rey and Kylo destroyed that room, did they sneak out? Like when he threw the tantrum and the stormtroopers got the hell out of there?
You read our minds.
Or did they kill them? Or do they really know the secret that they took out Snoke and the Praetorian guards?
He read our minds.
This is the podcast for him.
And,
yeah.
I will listen for your response.
He read our minds. Like, yeah. Are you kidding me?
We keep talking about this often. I think they took Snoke's ship and bailed.
we're not sure.
They're again paid by the guy that just died, and they bailed.
They just bailed? I could see it.
It was funny because, like, the first showing, I was like, all right, there's a mysterious two people right there.
Yeah.
And then the second time I was like, no, they're there. And then the third time I was like, where are they? like where'd they go? But it was, it was the same deal. Like the dignitaries, like, I don't, where'd they go?
Where'd they go? Right?
They're probably like, hey, this isn't gonna end good.
This is weird. We gotta get out. We gotta bail.
Yeah, we gotta bail.
I just imagine they went on lunch break.
We gotta bail.
Everything was fine. They had, he, you know, Snoke had some guests, but it was fine. You know, it's no big deal. He gets guests every once in a while. He's in control. He's very powerful. They get back from the 30-minute lunch break. Oh my god, what happened? It's just nuts. You know, like everything is like gone to hell. It's totally destroyed. He's dead. They're like, what do we do now?
Well, the First Order is a big organization. So I would say it's a state job. So at least an hour lunch, not 30 minutes. So,
well, that's true. That's true. Yeah. So, you got to point that kid.
So, I mean, they might have showed up after the fact, like Kylo waking up, talking to Hux, them leaving, and then them showing up being like, okay, everyone's gone. Snoke's dead. The red backdrop is burnt. We should leave.
Yeah, maybe
the ship's half gone.
Maybe it's time.
Happy New Year, Joe and Chris. It's Bill Jarnowski.
Boom.
I regret not being able to come on for the roundtable. And so I thought I would share just a list of things that kind of stuck with me from The Last Jedi. Not really going to, I mean, I love the movie, so I don't really need to get into reasons why I loved it. I'm just going to share some really cool moments, a little bit of, you know, wild speculation, some connections, things like that. So my first thing is a series of just moments that stick with me that I just thought were amazing. They were just powerful moments. The first thing is when the Raddus jumps to light speed through the supremacy and just tears a hole in that thing, and everything goes silent. And a lot of that had to do with more like the effect of it, which is the crowd goes quiet, but there's like this gasp and you can hear a few murmurings, and just the audience reaction. It's one of those things that will basically stick with me forever. That theater going moment, that first time that happened. I know a lot of people were really impressed with that scene. And I was as well. Moment number two is just one moment where Leia is by herself on Crait outside the bay door, the calm before the storm, the dire circumstances pinned to the corner. It just, man, that visual was just powerful. Kylo Ren, as he force guides that lightsaber through the body of Snoke into Rey's outstretched hand, man, that moment when it hit her hand, this is such such a awesome scene. I'm gonna
love that scene
in a minute.
I think about that every time.
And then Gwendolyn Christie's fighting moves, she really wasn't joking when she said that this was a super physically demanding role. And I know people, you know, myself included, kind of thought she got shortchanged as a character in this movie, but at least she got to kick some butt. I mean, those fighting moves were sick. That was a really well, choreographed and executed fight scene. And then my final kind of moment or just observation, I guess, is Maz Kanata. Is she the horniest being in the galaxy? She might be. Okay, so I have one little bit of wild speculation that I have no evidence for. I just imagine it would be really neat. What if Snoke's final act before dying was the forced possession of his 8 Praetorian guards, and he occupies their bodies as they're fighting Kylo and Rey? That would be pretty cool. Okay.
Huh. I like it.
My one big connection that I thought was interesting, and I've heard others mention this too, is there was Lord of the Rings imagery all over The Last Jedi. I mean, you had Snoke's wizardly looking glass. You had basically
Palantir,
the Battle of Helm's Deep with the glittering caves beneath.
True dad.
And the
true
tree. Chris, the tree. The tree, Chris.
He's doing it!
And then I have some kind of like things that I want to see come out of this, collector things, you know, story wise things. What I really want collecting wise is a scale model of that dreadnought. And I think it has a name. I don't remember what it's called, but it's that dreadnought that has those huge guns that drop down and
the
surface
cannons.
Bombardment cannons or whatever. I want a scale model of that, like a plastic model kit that I can build and weather and work on. I do want to see a novel titled Kylo Ren or something like that.
Yes,
that explores
I love this.
Turning to the dark side and his apprenticeship to Snoke.
We need more Kylo Ren.
Related him, I think with the way the movie went, going into it, I probably would have said, oh, this would be a book for after episode 9. But I mean, quite frankly, we're at the point where I think this book can happen. And, a lot of people are like, oh, well, Snoke was completely useless. I don't think so. I think that exploring his past would be really interesting. And I want to see it. I want to hear about it. And then I'd like to see a Republic era TV show about a Jedi Academy, almost like Hogwarts, but Jedi Academy kind of thing. I think would
all
be
right.
Really cool.
Luke and his
TV
boys
show. And I mean, that could possibly be animated or live action. I think I'd prefer live action, but that would be awesome. And it doesn't even have to be like Yoda era. It could be earlier than that, like almost like Old Republic or something.
Oh, cool. I could see that.
And then, guys, I have one random recommendation for you. If you haven't done so yet, you both need to go and watch The Toys That Made Us. Episode 1 is Star Wars. It's cool. It's a lot of the same stuff we've heard because, being kind of diehard Star Wars fans, we're familiar with that stuff. But Episode 3 is all He-Man. It's all the history of the He-Man toys
damn.
And that line and its influence. And they do interview Dolph Lundgren. And they have, they have a section of it that's all about that movie and how it was a flop and whatnot. But so guys, love the show. Keep it up. May the force be with you.
Well, he brought a ton
Bill
of
is the
points.
Man.
Yeah, we love Bill.
Yeah.
Bill, we love you.
And he queued up the best lead-in right now. I want to hear your thoughts on The Toys That Made Us.
Well, The Toys That Made Us was amazing. I watched all of them.
Yeah.
And he's 100% right. Dolph Lundgren's there. We met him. We all met him. We're
yeah.
all there. All
Dolph
three
was
of us.
Dolph was a man.
And yeah, he was awesome. And The Toys That Made Us, I highly recommend it. It's on Netflix. And the first episode is Kenner. So that was Kenner. And it's amazing. You got He-Man, you got G.I. Joe, you got Bobby. And there's four episodes. And it was probably the most enjoyable thing that I've watched in a long time.
Nice. Where does it rate, like, remember Plastic Galaxy documentary?
Take that to like more in depth.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's
all right.
It's like these guys, whoever did this, like they got like everybody involved, like everybody that worked on it, everyone that got their hands on it, and they just got every little piece out of them.
Wow.
Yeah, it was really well. Plastic Galaxy is great. I watched it. It was awesome.
Yeah, it's great.
Super enjoyable, and you see a lot of familiar faces from that on this.
Totally.
I really feel like they dug deep. Like I really would like them to keep going with it.
Cool, man.
Yeah. And
I gotta check it out. I'm checking out tonight.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm
watching
tonight.
You're gonna dude, it's gonna bring you back hardcore.
Oh, I can't wait. I want to.
Yeah. It's gonna bring you back hardcore.
Yeah.
Yeah, Bill, that was probably the best voicemail we've ever got. I love all the voicemails that we get, but Bill, you touched upon a lot of great things.
You talked about the trees.
The trees. That really got me going because I'll tell you now.
We've been talking about Bill and the trees two years now.
Well, this is the thing. Bill told me about the trees. I had
the
no
trees.
Idea about the trees because he told me about the comic book, The Trees.
The two
and,
trees.
Yeah,
double tree.
Yeah, and we saw the tree, and we know that Poe Dameron, I mean, dude, he's the best guy pilot in the galaxy.
Yeah.
I'm assuming because of he was brought up under one of these
next
trees.
Next to the trees, yeah.
Yeah, so, I mean, the trees bring a really higher power here.
Yeah.
And that's the whole thing. You know, he told me about the trees. That's why we say, hey, Bill, the trees, the two trees. That's why we say that.
It's true. Yeah. Bill had the idea that they were going to play a major part.
And they are.
The tree was the Jedi Temple.
It was there. We saw it.
It was the first Jedi Temple.
Yeah.
So I'm really glad we got to hear from Bill on this one. Because since 2015, he's been the guy who's been most looking forward to Episode 8. From everyone I know. So I'm really excited about that.
Mm.
So pretty cool. Man, I wanted to talk about Solo, but we're out of time.
Yeah.
We did a lot.
We have like 4 or 5 months.
Dwindling by the day.
Yeah, we have some time.
We have like 4 months left.
It's insane, man.
It's crazy,
we
dude.
Just got a Star Wars movie. We got another one.
I can't believe how quick this is.
Mm-hmm.
What a turnaround. You know? It's either going to be, like, an amazing movie, or I don't think there's going to be any middle ground on this. It's not going to be an F movie. It's either going to be, like, a flaming trash fire, or it's going to be amazing.
I feel like we're going to leave going, hey, that was a really fun, cool movie.
I think so, too.
I feel like that's what I'm going to get out of it.
I think they're like, I can't believe we just saw that.
Yeah, you need
like, we're going to be wow. Like,
you need to walk into that movie going, hey, listen, this is going to be a fun Han Solo movie.
Yeah, let's rock.
Let's rock. We're having fun here.
We're having fun. You know, let's go have some fun.
That's what I'm getting out of all of this. They're going to make a really cool Solo, young Solo movie.
Yeah.
You know, Chewbacca's going to be there. Lando's going to be there.
The Falcon might look all weird and wacky.
The Falcon's going to look a little
different. What have you done, my ship? Yeah. You know? Before the special modifications, maybe?
New characters, which we always love. New aliens.
Oh, yeah. A couple of ladies. Lando. Young Lando.
Yeah. Some ladies.
Young Lando.
Hopefully we see a hut.
Man, I want some young hut. Young Jabba.
Jabba. We got to see
Jabba. Ujabba.
Ujabba.
Solo.
Yeah.
You know?
Han
Mibuki.
Yeah, we got to see him.
Yeah, I want to see Young Greedo, maybe.
Ooh, I didn't even think of that.
Young Dengar.
Maybe, maybe. We
maybe a little Dengar. Yeah,
we can see something.
Maybe a Boba.
Boba, yeah.
Boba, ooh, Boba. Ooh, Boba.
Ooh, Boba.
Who knows? We can see them all. You know?
Sky's the limit on this one, guys.
Yeah, we can get real weird with this one. If they don't throw in goddamn hammerheads in this one.
We need
to go back. Yeah, old school aliens on this one.
We're revisiting the old school right now, so we're definitely going to see a lot of familiar faces. Well, I'm assuming we got.
We're going back to the cantina? He was hanging out. Dude.
It would be cool to be like, hey, it's like our old stomp, like me and you with the whistle. We always end up back there.
This place.
Yeah,
there's a reason we come
good
back.
Good food,
here.
Good drinks.
Yeah, nice.
It is what it is.
Yeah.
Is it a little sketchy? Yeah, but we like that.
We don't expect much, but you know what? No, everyone leaves us alone here.
Yeah.
I can murder a person here. No one will mess with me.
Yeah.
I'll throw a quarter.
Right.
I'll throw a quarter at the bar. It's fine. Do you think he ever went back? You know, he became a general.
Huh? No.
I think he came back. He probably bought that bar when he was older.
He probably already knew that he was in too deep.
You know?
He got in way too deep, dude. Married the princess, had a kid. Things didn't really shape out the way that he thought
he
was going
to. He started racing.
Yeah.
He became a race car driver.
Went back to the way that things were.
Just like Lucas.
Yeah.
True.
He liked his race cars.
He became a race car driver. That's what he was doing. You know, training other kids to race and stuff like that.
And then he's hauling Wrath Tars.
Yeah, he went dirty. He went, you know?
There's good money in this.
Yeah. Like, you're a millionaire. You're a millionaire beyond comparison. Well, you can make some good money here, though.
Mm.
Wrath Tars. Chewie had a family. He went back to his family and hung out. You know?
Yeah.
And he's like, Chewie, we got some Wrath Tars here. He's like, what's going on?
I like this thing.
What is going on with this? Look at this thing. These things are terrible. Yeah. What are we doing?
They're gross, but they're cool.
You don't need the money, hon. You're a millionaire.
Yeah, I think you're okay.
Yeah. All right. You know? If you just go home, everything would be fine.
Are you a great war hero?
Meh.
He was like,
used to be. Yeah, that's not Solo. That's our analysis. Yes. These shows go too fast.
They do go fast.
Way too fast. I can't believe it. We're already here again. At the end.
Friends, Star Wars, talking. Forget about
it. It just goes too fast. We could be here all night. And we have many a time. Many a time. Guys, thank you so much for listening to Brews and Blasters. You know where to find us. Brewsandblasters.ninja. That's where you find everything we're doing. You know, show notes, pictures, posts.
We're doing it.
Links, everything you need. It's all there. BrewsandBlasters.ninja. You find all of our shows. You know where you can find us. You know where you can subscribe. We're on Spotify. New one.
That's huge.
It's easy. Look it up and, you know, search in Spotify. We're there. Boom. We're also on iTunes. You know that. you know? But wherever you want to listen to podcasts, wherever you're having a good time, just find us there. Subscribe. Tell a friend to subscribe. Tell your father to subscribe. Tell your mother to subscribe.
They'll like it.
You can have a sister, tell her to subscribe too. Brother?
A sister.
Sister. Tell them all to subscribe. Make it happen. Better yet, just subscribe them. You know, you know. What? I don't know. Don't get weird. All right? Don't get weird. Just subscribe. All right. Let's have a good time. Let's all join the party. That's all I'm saying. We just want to have a couple of super cools, talk about Star Wars.
That's it.
What are we doing here?
We're simple
What's
men.
Happening? Brews and Blasters, you know that, on Twitter. Follow us there. Facebook. Follow us on Facebook. Instagram. Instafans got the new... He's laughing. Like I just invented Instagram. Instagram people got the preview of our big announcement last week.
They did.
They got the preview.
Yeah, oh, they did. That's sure
yeah,
they did.
That's it. So, you know, subscribe there. You never know what we'll say. It's crazy. Brews and Blasters, RetroZap.com. Get those emails. What are you eating? You like poached eggs? You want to talk about Last Jedi? Let's hit it up. 978-219-6688. That's our voicemail. You know where to find us. Get a t-shirt. Get some weird Beaumont Monk t-shirts. They're fun.
Oh, they're the best.
They're the best. It's my favorite shirt ever.
It is. I wear it often.
Yeah. I can't wait for more solo talk, more Last Jedi talk. We have so much to discuss. But until then, Godspeed Rebels. Sakala. And tell the Kanji Club. We'll see you later, guys. Bye. I'm afraid the party's canceled, but my summer's never show. I don't know what was meant for, so I was far from it, no. Before it's getting ready, man, we get too much. I don't know what was summer, but he's wicked clutch. Beef up.